This video is going to go over how the field tags work in the MailChimp widget. When you open up the widget options, you'll see a section called field tags down here. The field tags in this section show what the field tags need to be inside MailChimp depending on what input you use in the widget. That probably sounds super confusing, but it will make sense by the end of this video. So the first one on this list is email. The email tag is probably not something that you're going to have to worry about because it is extremely likely that MailChimp already assigned email for the field tag inside MailChimp. Now, if you're using the first name and last name, then the field tags inside MailChimp need to be FName and LName, and everything needs to be written in all caps. Now, I'll show you what that needs to look like inside MailChimp. Go over to MailChimp, open up your list, and then click Sign Up Forms, then General Forms, and then scroll down. To be able to get the first and last name when someone enters it into the widget, we need to add a first and last name input field to MailChimp. So to do that, we're going to add two text fields. So you're going to click Text, and then click it again. Okay, so on this first one, we're going to change the field label to first name. Then the field tag, we need to change that to, in all caps, enter FName. And then click Save Field. Then on this next one, we're going to do a similar thing. We're going to change the field label to last name. And then the field tag, we're going to change that to LName. And then click Save Field. Alright, now that has made it so that we can now capture the first and last name when someone enters it into the widget. And I'll show you a demonstration of that real quick. So first I'm going to get rid of the three subscribers for this form. So now I'm going to switch back over into Muse and export the page to the browser. Now I'll enter in my information. Click Submit. So far everything looks good. Now I'm going to go confirm the subscription, and once I do, I will show you what it looks like inside MailChimp. Alright, I've confirmed the subscription, and now when I click Reload, it should show my information, including my first and last name. There it is. Now that's how it works for every input, and I will just show you one more example real quick. So I'm going to go back over into Muse. For the second example, I'm going to add the input fields that are needed for someone to be able to add their address to the widget. So if you open up the widget, all of the widgets that have multiple rows have a new feature that's a toggle labeled Add Address. And when you toggle that on, it inserts the input fields that are needed for someone to be able to add their address. So now we need to go into MailChimp and add an address to our form. Before we do that though, we need to see what the field tag is for adding an address. So open up the field tags, and if you look at address, surprisingly, the field tag for address is the word address in all caps. So we'll go over into MailChimp, and inside our list, click Sign Up Forms again, then General Forms, then scroll down and find address. Click it. Then the field label address, that's great. Then the field tag, we need to write address. And then click Save. I'm going to go back over into Muse again, export the site to the browser, then enter my information, but I'm going to change the email since that email is already subscribed to the list. Then click Submit. Again, everything looks good. Now I'm going to go confirm the email and then show you what it looks like inside MailChimp. Alright, so I've confirmed the email, so now I'm just going to go into List and see how it turned out. So there everything is. So you got my first and last name, obviously the email, and then my address. And that is how the field tags work inside the MailChimp widgets.